मित्रांनो, मागच्या काही लेक्चर्स पासून वी आर डिस्कसिंग इंटरफेरन्स फिनॉमिना इन हाउ द इंटरफेरन्स ऑकर्स अँड इंटरफेरन्स इन थिन फिल्म due to reflected and transmitted light, then wedge-shaped thin films, then Newton's rings, and by which here how the Newton's rings are formed, and thereby what is the condition for bright and dark rings. So we see here, friends, as we know that the interference pattern is occurs due to light reflected from upper and lower surface of air film. See now, in this is a plain glass plate, this is a plano convex glass plate, and in between these two glass plates here is the air film. This gap is of a air film, and the air film can be considered as a special case of wedge-shaped film. In this case, the wedge angle made between the plane glass plate and the tangent from the line of contact, this is line of contact here, the curved surface of plano convex lens is as shown in this figure. See, this is the incident light. From this incident light, this is incident through this plano convex and plain glass plate through the air film, and is reflected. It is partly reflected from plano convex and partly from the plain glass plate. And in this way, here we get the rings. This distance is r, if we can say a radius of curvature, and this is a distance p. And here they have been given n is nothing but a refractive index, value of refractive index. See here. Now we have to go for the condition bright as well as dark rings. Then the path difference between two interfacing rays reflected by air film is nothing but this sign, this delta symbol is nothing but the path difference between the two interfacing rays equals to twice mu 2 cos of r plus theta minus lambda by 2. Now see here, mu is the reflective index of the air film, and p is the thickness of air film. Here is the formation of air film takes place, and p is the thickness, and mu is the refractive index of the air film at the point of reflection, and theta is nothing but the angle of wedge. This is the angle of wedge which we can observe in the diagram. In this case, light normally falls on the plano convex lens for the refraction angle r equal to 0. Further, as we use a lens of focal length of a wedge, it is very small. Therefore, cos of r plus theta equal to cos of theta, and cos of theta means if the angle is very small, that is 0, and cos of 0 equals to 1. And by putting the this cos of r plus theta means 1. Again, here mu is the refractive index, and see this mu is here, its value is 1. And by putting the value here, if we are going to write this path difference between two interfacing rays, delta equal to, we will keep this mu as it is, twice mu t, and this cos of r plus theta is nothing but 1, therefore minus lambda by t. And at the point of contact, t equals to 0, therefore delta equal to lambda by 2, and this is the condition of minima. Hence, at center or at a point of contact, there is a dark point. Then, what is the condition for bright ray or maxima? See, the basic condition of bright rings is it should have a path difference equals to n lambda. Here n is nothing but the number of rings here, 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. is the number of rings. Here, as we discussed that in this diagram, here you have to omit or don't keep in mind this n equal to 1.4368. These values you have to forget here, and therefore if we having this basic formula, that is delta equal to n lambda. Now see what we have been defined here, n lambda. This is a delta 2 mu t minus lambda by 2. Therefore, we will put here the value of delta 2 mu t minus lambda by 2 equals to n lambda, where n is 0, 1, 2, 3 number of fringes, and therefore twice mu t equals to, yes, twice mu t equals to, what is the lambda by 2? It is equal to n lambda, he says n lambda. Then n lambda, what we have to, by putting this twice mu 2 in this side, it will be twice n plus 1 by 2 into lambda, and it is nothing but twice mu t equals to 2n minus 1 by 2 into lambda, where n equals to 1, 2, 3. Again, these are number of fringes, and when we have to get a condition, means we are getting the condition for bright ring is nothing but the, if this mu, we are going to put the value of mu as a 1, then twice t equals to 2n plus, here we have to write 1 plus 1, and see here, because twice t minus lambda by 2 is the condition here which we got here, because here again it twice n plus 1, because the basic equation, if you go through that equation, that is nothing but the optical path difference delta equals to twice mu t cos of r minus lambda by 2. This is the equation here, I think, yes, this is the equation, twice mu t cos of r C cos of R having a value, or cos of means it is value is 1, therefore we will neglect it, and as we are going to neglect it, then twice mu t here minus lambda by 2 equals to n lambda, this n lambda we will put here, and therefore twice mu t, again this factor will be twice this we have to do the further calculations and put the values, and it will nothing but see here automatically we get twice mu t in bracket twice n minus 1 upon 2 into lambda. See, once again we can simplify it by taking this refractive index as a 1, twice t equals to in bracket twice n minus 1 upon 2 into lambda. This is the condition for bright ring, and what about the condition for dark ring? See here friends, the condition for dark ring, we will write the optical path difference equal to 2n plus 1 into lambda by 2, and for this dark ring we will put the values here twice t minus lambda by 2 equals to twice n into lambda by 2. This twice t means what? Twice t, again we have to see the basic equation here, this equation, optical path difference is nothing but 2, value of refractive index is 1, therefore twice t minus lambda by 2, and therefore twice t minus lambda by 2 equals to in bracket twice n plus 1 into lambda by 2, and twice t equals to n lambda. This is nothing but the condition for dark ring, or we can say a minima. Thus corresponding number, that is number of fringes, n equals to 1, 2, 3, etc. We observe first, second, third, etc. bright or dark rings in Newton's ring experiment. For locating point of constant thickness in circle, so fringes are circular rings. See friends, by which we are able to see through the Newton's ring experiment which are the bright rings, which are the dark rings, and by locating their positions and further calculations, or by which we are able to determine the wavelength of light or source used for the Newton's ring experiments, how the wavelength of that light can be determined, we will discuss it in a next lecture.
Friends, in last lecture we already discussed the phenomenon or the procedure how we get the Newton's rings by reflected light. As we discussed that it is nothing but a assembly of plano-convex lens, means the convex side of lens is kept on a plain glass plate, and due to which there is a formation of air film takes place, and due to that air film, when we are going to focus or incident a sodium source, then due to the plain glass plate which is situated at 45 degree angle, the light is partly reflected. It goes or enters to the ear film, and due to which we are observing the circular fringes which having a same center, due to which we can say that rings are concentric one. And now again the next part is why we are going to observing the interference pattern or the concentric rings by this experiment. See, the purpose or the application of this experiment is to determine the wavelength of the source which we are using in this experiment. Therefore, we will see how it can be determined. See now, a plano convex lens, as we have been discussed, is of a larger radius of curvature. We can say about 100 centimeter is kept on a flat glass plate, just discussed. Then sodium vapor lamp is kept before it. Sodium vapor means the yellow light which is coming from the source falls on the glass plate, which is held at a 45 degree, just we have discussed it. The microscope then is adjusted for observing the circular rings, and that circular rings we have to adjust it to come into the focus. The center of the cross wire, see, cross wire means in this way, from the eyepiece when we are observing, we can see the cross wires in this way. The concept of cross wires we have been discussed in first chapter also, when we were discussing about Huygens and Ramsden's eyepieces. At that time, in which the Huygens eyepiece having a cross wires, then the center of the dark spot we have to adjust here the cross wire. Then now we will turning the screw of the microscope is moved on the carriage slowly towards one side, say right side. See, if we are going to adjust the cross wire in this fashion, here we are observing the concentric circular rings. Concentric means which having a same center. In this fashion we can observe it. It is a number of rings in this way. See, this is a cross wire. Then there is a carriage on traveling microscope, and by screwing it we can say it is focused on the right hand side, as the cross wire again moves in this way. Means if we have been taken here will be the cross wire. We have to adjust it at the edge of this circular rings, and that rings, the field of view dark rings are counted. Then the movement is stopped when the 22nd ring is reached. For example, we are here, this may be a 22nd ring, For this ring, again, for this ring, we can take the microscope reading, that is MSR, then CSR, then CSR into LC, and then total. If this is A, this is B, then this B into LC and then total, means from which we get the diameter in this way. Again, for left hand side, again if we have been adjusted the cross wire here for the 22nd ring, then by getting the difference of these rings, we will get the diameter of the 22nd ring. In this way, then the microscope is moved in the opposite direction and stopped at the 20th, then 19th dark rings. The vertical cross wire is made tangential to the 19th ring, and the reading is noted with the help of the scale, which is graduated on the carriage. Thus, we are able to see the 19th ring, then 18th, 17th, 16th in this way, up to 5th dark ring. Now the microscope is moved quickly to the left side again. Again the same process up to the 5th dark ring. The crosswise is again made tangential to the 5th dark ring, and its position is noted. Position is noted means we have to note the main scale reading as well as circular scale reading, and multiply it CSR by least count of a traveling microscope, and the difference between these readings on the right and the left side of the 5th dark ring gives its diameter value. We get a diameter value, and the procedure is repeated till the 19th ring is reached and its reading is noted. See friends, from this data, from the value of the diameters, the squares of the diameters are to be calculated, and then this type of graph is plotted. In this x-axis we have to plot m, that is the number of rings, and d square m. This suffix m is nothing but again the number of rings and diameter square. Then what happens, we get a straight line graph, straight line nature of the graph as shown in this figure. And as we know, the formula d square suffix m is 4 m lambda r, and for the m plus p ring, d square m plus p, this one d square m plus p, that is 4 m plus p into lambda by r. By getting a difference between these diameters, then lambda equals to d square m plus p minus d square m upon 4 p r. All these things are given in this graph, and the slope of the straight line gives this slope. This slope is calculated here, and this value of the slope gives the value of 4 lambda r. In this way, lambda equals to slope upon 4 r, and therefore the radius of curvature r of the lens to be determined using a spirometer, and lambda is computed with the help of the above equation. Therefore, here from this experiment, we are able to find out the wavelength of the light or a source which we are using for this experiment. Thank you very much.